Now you are in the present. You have left your past behind, and your future lies ahead of you. If you ask yourself, how do you want your future to be? You will easily answer, I don't know. I have no idea. What I do know is what I don't want to happen. You will usually know what you like and dislike about your present. And if you think about it, you will also realize what you liked and disliked about your past. However, it is more than likely that the uncertainty about what you want for your future will remain. Usually we are taught from a young age all kinds of knowledge, but we are not taught to trust ourselves. Believing in yourself and having a clear idea of what you want might be branded by many as arrogance. Son, what you have to do is work hard, make sacrifices, and accept your fate. Daydreaming is a waste of time. There will always be people to remind you that this is like the story of the milkmaid and her pail, a rather curious fable that someone must have made up so everyone else would stop dreaming. It's a pity because, in fact, the way to achieve your goals is to dream of what you want, to put an expiration date to your dream, and then work to achieve it. You can do very well in the future. It all depends on what you believe. The first thing you need to do is to be aware of some simple concepts, understand them, and implement them. Let's start with the concept of comfort zone. This is the metaphorical area in which you are when you move into an environment you control. In it, things will be familiar and comfortable to you, whether pleasant or not. For example, to be stuck in traffic every day is to be within your comfort zone because that's what you know. Your boss harping on you in the office belongs to your comfort zone because that's what you know. Having fun or fighting with your partner is your comfort zone because that's what you know. Your habits, your routines, your skills, your knowledge, your attitudes, and your behavior are also part of your comfort zone. Around your comfort zone is your learning zone. This is the area you leave for in order to expand your worldview. And you do it while learning new languages, traveling to unknown countries, having new experiences, enriching your points of view, modifying your habits, getting to know other cultures, or meeting up with new customers. This is where we observe, experiment, compare, learn, enjoy. There are people who are passionate about this, and so they regularly gravitate towards their learning zone. For others, however, it's a scary thing to do, and to avoid it, they will only move within their comfort zone, since leaving it, it's considered dangerous. Beyond your learning zone is what we call the panic zone or no experience zone. Those who do not want you to move around it, who are usually the ones that never go out of their comfort zone, will say it is the area where really, really serious things can happen. It's like Cape Finisterre. Beyond it, the world ends. Don't go out. It will be terrible. What if something goes wrong? Well, but what if I get it right? The latter is only said by those who believe that this area is actually the magic zone. The area in which wonderful things can happen to you. Things that you still don't know because you haven't been there. It's the big challenges zone. Some people believe that if they go to the magic zone, they can't turn back. That your comfort zone disappears. This is not true. Leaving means to broaden your comfort and learning zones. Change does not mean to lose what you had. It means that you add. Change is actually development. This might seem as being afraid of the unknown, but it is actually being afraid to lose what you have, or even worse, losing who you are. Next, you'll have to consider the emotional tension and the creative tension. They operate as two opposing forces, the first pulling you into your comfort zone, and the second making you move outwards. To be able to move forward, you will have to get your motivation to emerge victorious against your fears. You will have to work on your emotional tension, especially on the fears caused by leaving the comfort zone. Fear of what will the people say, fear of failure, fear of ridicule and shame. You will have to recognize and deal with them. Are you wondering how you can do it? Believe in yourself. You are the star of your own life. Whatever you don't decide, others will decide it for you. By properly managing your fears, your self-esteem will grow, and this will give you a new opportunity-filled vision of reality. You will then be able to better choose your objective, to have a clear idea of your dream, to find a what that motivates you. Afterwards, you will compare your point of departure with your destination, and you will easily feel as if shrinking. It is perfectly all right. You will become aware of what you need to learn. It will be useful to recall your origins, your values, your principles, and to reflect on your personal mission in life. To help keep the creative tension and not to give in to the emotional tension, you will want to think about your personal vision. What is beyond that dream? What do you want to reach your dream for? As soon as you transform your limiting prejudices, trust in yourself and your dream, and understand why and what you are doing it for, the time will have come for you to take action and leave behind your comfort zone. You will experience the joy of learning to pursue your dreams. You may initially feel hardly competent and vulnerable and think that it's risky. It's okay. You don't know everything, for you are human after all. You're learning. Congratulations. You are moving forward towards your dream. What you need to begin recovering your sense of competence is to return to your comfort zone for the personal resources you certainly have and that being in a hurry, you forgot to use. Take whatever necessary, but be patient with your training, confident in your goal, have your strategy well prepared, be persevering and positive, and sooner than you think, your dream will come true. Do you dare to dream? Innovation.